and gentlemen, tonight the self-protectionist Union of Nations that calls itself the European Union, that seeks to dictate terms to India, has suddenly caved in. Just 24 hours back, they refused free movement for fully vaccinated Indians, especially those who have been administered the Covishield vaccine manufactured by Serum Institute of India, the largest vaccine manufacturer in India and probably the world. Tonight, at least 9 nations associated with the European Union have lifted restrictions on Covishield and assured those administered in India with a Covishield vaccine will be given a green pass, including Germany, Switzerland and Spain. This after Team India read the riot act to its European counterparts, warning them of getting the same treatment on arrival in India if they don't accept India's demand. Tonight, India's foreign ministry has assured that this is just the beginning. All countries belonging to the European Union or the continent of Europe will have to fall in line, considering the fact that the formula used by Oxford's AstraZeneca vaccine is being used by India's Serum Institute for Covishield. And if Oxford AstraZeneca, produced in the UK or elsewhere in the world, is going to be given a green pass, then there is no reason why Indians should not be given the same treatment. But the nitpicking and vaccine racism policy adopted by the EU nations is slowly crumbling. It's just a matter of time before all nations issue this green pass for Indian citizens. Not just the EU turnaround in 24 hours, Modi diplomacy has yielded results for its robust positioning and parlays with big nations in the past. In the last 18 months alone, India has successfully snubbed the 370 bogey raised by Pakistan and its allies across the globe at international fora. India took the first step to counter China's bullying tactics in banning its digital footprint in India, which was followed by the US by the banning of several Chinese apps in India. India also enjoying a resounding support at G7 as its vaccine maitri policy raises goodwill across the globe. But obviously, the opposition still has a problem with the government.
It is for the authorities concerned to decide. But our contention is that whatever vaccine is being given to the people, that should be accepted by all international bodies or all countries, subject to clinical test and other tests. But if it does not happen, then it is a very sorry matter, very alarming situation.
It's good that the European Union has approved the Covishield vaccine for travel in Europe. But at the moment, who's going to Europe? As all international flights are banned at least up till the 31st of July or maybe more. The need of the hour is to vaccinate as quickly as possible. In Uttar Pradesh, the Yogi government had promised that from July 1, that is today, we are going to vaccinate at least 10 to 12 lakh people every day. But it is very unfortunate that more than 5,000 vaccination centers only in Uttar Pradesh have been locked up due to the shortage or non-availability of vaccines.
And that, ladies and gentlemen, brings me to the legitimate question on the news hour tonight. Has India's vaccine diplomacy been a big success? That's the question and the debate. Hashtag India Vax Passport Win. That's the debate on the other side.
You're watching the News Hour at 9. Debate number 1 on Times Now. Super Prime Time.
Joining me tonight, Gaurav Bhatia, National Spokesperson of the BJP. Smita Prakash, editor of ANI. Sanjay Jha, suspended Congress leader. Also joining me tonight is Sujata Paul, political analyst. But my first question goes to senior Trinamool Congress member of parliament, Professor Saugata Roy. Professor Saugata Roy, would you think that what the Ministry of External Affairs and India with its vaccine diplomacy has achieved today is a big victory Because in 24 hours alone, they've had a U-turn from 9 countries in the European Union and some other European countries as well, which have now allowed green passing of the Covishield vaccinated Indian travelers abroad. You know, normally this is a big issue when it comes up for a country, and it takes days and weeks to negotiate through these things. 24 hours, Modi diplomacy wins a huge victory for India. Would you acknowledge that today, Professor Roy?
I do not give the credit wholly to Modi diplomacy. We have not had a major victory, but we have a win. 9 countries, including Spain, Estonia, Switzerland, Iceland, Slovenia, Greece, Austria, Germany, they have given clearance to Covishield manufactured by Serum Institute of India as far as passengers traveling to those countries are concerned. You have to remember that European Union consists of 27 countries, and the other countries have not given the clearance. The main credit should go to Adar Poonawalla, the Serum Institute of India chairman, who has been lobbying and who has said repeatedly that in a few weeks' time, Covishield will be allowed in European Union by the European Medicine Agency. That the External Affairs Ministry did some diplomacy is due to them. It's nothing much, but they have done something, but the major task remains, and part of the credit should go to Adar Poonawalla of the Serum Institute of India. India yesterday talked tough and saying that we'll be reciprocal. If they don't allow our vaccines, we shall not allow their vaccines into India. But ultimately, our vaccines have to pass the European barrier. And you have to remember that the win is only for Covishield, manufactured by Serum Institute with collaboration from Oxford, AstraZeneca. Covishield, which is the Indian government's vaccine, has not received any clearance. It is made by ICMR and Bharat Biotech.
Okay.
It is not acceptable. So we have a lot of work to do.
All right.
And the Modi diplomacy should not try and win plaudits, nor should Times Now credit them with achieving more than what they've achieved.
All right. Fair point. Gaurav Bhatia,
I think lot of work,
Professor Saugata Roy says
remains
that you
done.
Have a lot of ground to cover. Yeah, because Covishield gets the green signal, but only 9 out of the 27 countries. And he says, it's only Covishield. What about Covaxin? So, it's too early to celebrate. Respond to him, Mr. Gaurav Bhatia.
Navika, it seems the thrust of his argument is that the credit should go to the Serum Institute of India and not to the government. I would only say that this is not a fight about taking credit. Rather, it shows that India pressed hard its demand that there should be mutual reciprocity. And we have seen in a very short span of time, 24 hours and 36 hours, 9 nations have responded positively. What does it show? It shows that India is a nation which knows how to ensure that our demands are met, especially when they are justified. And yes, India is not only pressing for Covishield to be cleared by the EMA, rather it's also saying that Covaxin should also be brought under that list so that there is no inconvenience to the Indians who are traveling to these European countries. And let us also not forget the External Affairs Ministry is taking up the issue with the other nations. And this is just a start. And within a very short span of time, we will see that other countries also follow suit. And there is a reason. Because India has also said that if you want a clear passage for the European visitors coming to India, you will have to reciprocate. And it's a very reasonable demand. I think the opposition today can be summarized in one line. Do din ki chandni, fir andheri raat. So they wait for these opportunities, Navika, that they can celebrate. And they feel India will fail. But India under Narendra Modi ji will never fail. Rather, we saw during the second wave of COVID that came, all the nations around the globe, they helped and they came forward to ensure that India does well to defeat the pandemic. And that is the current scenario when it comes to the global stage and India's position.
Well, let me get in Sanjay Jha. Sanjay Jha, do you think the opposition always picks up a battle which tends to somewhere or the other take away the sense of resolve that India comes out with? It's all very well to be cynical. It's all very well to have a little bit of a, critical eye on the way we are going. No time to celebrate for sure, because we don't know when the third wave is going to come. We don't know when, vaccines will be available for every Indian. Yes, there are many battles on the way. But to say this is an Aadhaar Poonawala victory, not a government victory. The fact is Aadhaar Poonawala is also backed. If the government did not, actually take a position that the reciprocity will not exist unless it took that tough position and took it in a jiffy. Decision making is fast. No time is lost between one action and the reaction coming in from India. And the fact that this vaccine diplomacy is not the only thing. Talk about Chinese apps, talk about the fact that after the abrogation of Article 370, how the world, Pakistan could have ruffled a few feathers and tried to pick this issue up. The Modi brand of politics and diplomacy has prevented that from happening. And to that extent, just to that extent, shouldn't we on such an occasion think of it as an Indian victory rather than just a Modi or a BJP victory? Why don't we all feel proud about the fact that India has managed to do this?
Well, Navika, whatever development has happened is what we would call as pro forma. This is regular procedure and process. You see, the AstraZeneca is approved in Europe because it has got a certain brand name that is locally familiar to the EMA, which is the European Medical Agency. Now, it's the same vaccine which we're using in India. So the delay, whatever it may be, is only process driven. Obviously, the applications weren't made on time, but it has to be willy-nilly approved. So I really don't see any credit going to either the government or to Aadhaar Poonawala. This is the way it operates all over the world. Covishield is approved by WHO. So I really don't see any problem. And at the end of the day, this is the way it ought to work. And also don't forget, Navika, the second point. The EMA has been very clear that member states of the European Union can approve any vaccine that they like, which is why these 9 countries we talked about, including Austria, Germany, Switzerland, etc., have approved Covishield because they know it is another name of AstraZeneca. So I really see no heroism here. There is no need for any spectacular chest beating. It is the way business operates all over the world. My only objection here will be to Gaurav here, or the government, not Gaurav, I don't blame Gaurav for this. Why is the government talking about reciprocity? You see, this is where the problem of the government is in posturing and appearing to be very patriotic and nationalistic. Doesn't Mr. Jaishankar know that we ourselves have inked Moderna, Pfizer and Johnson? So are you going to say, is the government of India going to say that we will not allow you if you are vaccinated with a Moderna, Pfizer and Johnson when we ourselves have got them in our country? I mean, it's a very absurd, situation, honestly.
Can I respond now?
The government needs to approach this with a lot more of, I think, maturity. Diplomacy, heroism, scoring brownie points. I'm sorry. We need to work in a professional manner transparent manner.
Wish to respond.
And I believe that whatever delay has happened is probably pro forma and procedural. And my last point is, at the moment, you know, many of the countries are not even having flights between our countries, right? So there is enough time to do it. And I would request Gaurav to put pressure on the WHO to approve Covaxin, because you're getting Covaxin a terrible name with the whole Brazil episode. So, you know, I think the government needs to understand these larger ramifications, focus on Covaxin getting WHO approval, and not waste their time trying to score these little brownie points and saying, we want to take credit. Credit for what?
Well, it's find the same Gaurav, I'm coming to you. I'm coming to you. But I want to get a sense from Smita Prakash first. Smita Prakash, you know, it's a question of damned if you do and damned if you don't. Now, Smita, you know, yesterday when Indians were not getting the green pass to travel in Europe, there was opposition. Look at what they've done. There was outrage on social media, people talking and political parties. Oh, you know, India doesn't have its act together. Vaccination, shortages, policy has done a flip-flop. Now look at this. Europe doesn't even recognize it. In UK, you know, Oxford, AstraZeneca is produced, recognized, but India can't get it done. Today, when India gets it done, the goalpost changes. The goalpost becomes, are you Covaxin kyun nahi karwaya? Covaxin is your real test. You know, that is what you should have got done. And then they say that the government is wasting its time today. Yesterday, they were all outraged, red in the face, saying, oh God, you know, India ki izzat kam ho gayi. Today, they are saying, are kisne mana? Slovenia, Greece, Iceland, Ireland, Estonia. What's the big deal? There are 27 other countries which haven't recognized you still. Smita, how does this work?
So, Navika, people who are going to CARP are going to CARP regardless of what the issue is and how far we have won or lost in that. I can't disagree more with Sanjay Jha. See, I understand that there are processes, but we are under this mistaken assumption to stand up to Western nation processes which are biased against developing nations such as India or say the Caribbean and African nations is something that we should accept. No, we have to stand up to it. And it has to be done behind closed doors if needed. It can be done diplomatically. It can be done by muscle flexing. That's all a part of what comes under the ambit of diplomacy. The reality is that, you know, most of us think that, the EU is a, you know, is a developed nations bloc, and they should be egalitarian, inclusive. But the reality is that this bloc is protectionist. It's protectionist in favor of their own manufacturers. There are 17 vaccines which are being used in this world today. Only 4 are approved by EU. Individually they can, but as EU as a bloc, there are just 4. And mind you, these are processes. You can't go back and forth. Now, after India said that there will be reciprocal regimes in place, then they turn around and some of the countries have said, oh, okay, fine. These will be approved. Travel between these countries are approved. That is 9 European nations. They will say, okay, fine. Covishield jab allowed to travel. Hopefully, Covaxin will also follow. And I think credit where it should be, whether it is to Aadhar Poonawalla. And by the way, I'd like to point out Aadhar, in case anybody doesn't know, Aadhar Poonawalla is also an Indian. He's not Chinese, right? So if it's Aadhar Poonawalla's victory, if it is Modi victory, Jai Shankar victory, or anybody's victory, it is an India victory. And maybe not just a victory, it is just a process, but a process where we have won the day. So I think there is reason enough to feel, and especially in these days of pandemic, even the mildest thing coming in our favor, I think is fine. If self-interest propels the EU group, then self-interest has to be part of Indian diplomacy too. And in this time when discriminatory procedures during a pandemic, I think it's discriminatory at worst and problematic at best. There is no vaccine equity in this world today. And if we stand up for our rights, I think countries in Asia, in Africa, and in the Caribbean will look up to us and say that what the EU is doing is something which is unjust and it is indefensible. As a bloc, they should not and they have not covered themselves in glory in this step. And I'm glad that there has been a rework in the past 24 hours.
Navika's short response.
Sanjay Jha responding back to Smita.
Yeah, Navika,
yes,
that was,
yes, go
that
ahead.
Was, you know, one can wax eloquent, but, you know, that's a whole lot of mumbo jumbo you heard from Smita. I'm sorry, with due respect, I totally disagree with you. You talked about vaccine equity. Do you know that when India actually banned its exports, which was part of the global program, you actually allowed countries in Africa to suffer and probably even die because we did not fulfill our obligations. Adar Poonawalla could not fulfill his obligations. By the way, Adar Poonawalla got sued by AstraZeneca because India forced him not to export. And you're giving a lecture on vaccine equity? Please do your homework. And the larger point I made
is that you can't harp with the hair, and you can't do that. You know, Gaurav Bhatia, allow me to get Gaurav Bhatia. Gaurav Bhatia,
a villain today.
No.
That's not the only problem. Calling what you say is mumbo jumbo. What Sanjay Jha is saying is mumbo jumbo. Because Gaurav Bhatia, you know, when India was exporting, they were beating their chest and saying, "Arey, hamare liye hai nahi, aap de rahe ho." Before that, they were saying, "Oh, Covaxin has not been tested. Covaxin test results have not been put out. What is the efficacy? What is the reaction on Indians? That has not been put out." Who was the first one to bring down the credibility of the Covaxin, which is something that India will have to pay for? Indians created the doubts. And as Smita Prakash said, not mumbo jumbo, absolutely correct. There is a discriminatory world out there. And when Indians actually pan their own vaccine, their own discoveries in the scientific system, the world's not going to recognize it. And today, you're putting the blame back on the government and saying, "Tum Covaxin nahi kara sake. Arey, tumne Africa ko export nahi kiya." Kamal hai.
Okay, so Navika, this is the strange feature about the opposition parties. They don't change the goalpost. They run with the goalpost. Earlier, when international commitments were being honored, these people came out and they said, "How dare you send our vaccine to these countries? They should be first used in India to protect our citizens." And rightly so, we had done that. Now, today, assuming for the sake of argument, Adar Poonawalla did not fulfill his obligations to provide vaccine to other countries, and he gave priority to India. Being an Indian, I would still applaud him, just like other Indians would. You know, we will deal with the other obligations part later. But Sanjay, my friend, I would like to tell you one thing. This government is not fulfilling its obligations because we want to indulge in chest humping. You know, there are many things that Narendra Modi ji is tirelessly working to complete for the citizens, but we are not doing chest humping. But I must tell you, Mamata Banerjee, one of your favorites, claimed credit because she wrote a letter. These nine countries actually decided to give approval to India. Now, is that true? So please do not indulge in chest thumping, and please do not do chest whining also, chest beating and whining, because it doesn't help the cause of our country if you try to politicize everything. And like Navika rightly said, Narendra Modi ji's government is clear and there is clarity and no confusion. But look at the U-turns of the opposition. Sometimes they say, "Covaxin is not safe." Now they are saying, "Covaxin, aur de do, aur de do." Pehle kehte hain, decent.
Well, we've lost the audio of Gaurav Bhatia. I'll go back to him. But I want to get in Saugata Roy, Professor Saugata Roy. Professor Saugata Roy, I want to just ask you one question. And the question here is, and I don't agree with Mr. Gaurav Bhatia that there is no confusion in the government. There has been confusion. The vaccination policy, the way it's done, its ups and downs, clearly shows that there was confusion initially 45 plus and 60 plus, and then suddenly 18 to 44, then the scarcity of vaccination. So there have been flip-flops, and no confusion is not a comment that I'm making. That was Gaurav Bhatia's comment. But I'm saying on this score, at least, the opposition hasn't really covered itself in glory when it ran down Covaxin in the first place. And when the world begins to question, then you begin to ask, the government, why haven't you been able to convince the rest of the world that Covaxin is also that should be recognized? The Indians didn't recognize it. Political parties said this is a BJP vaccine. This will cause impotency. I want to ask you, Saugata Roy, should we not as Indians worry about why we have beaten down our own brand of, homemade, homegrown Atmanirbhar vaccine?
No, Navika, I would say that developing Covaxin by the Bharat Biotech and ICMR was creditable. But we should have got international approvals at an early date. Covaxin still lacks WHO and other international approvals. And look at what the headlines today say, that Brazil suspends Covaxin. Brazil says that all the order will be cancelled over graft allegation. Temporary suspension of 20 million doses. So we have not covered ourselves with glory with Covaxin, one. Two, look at the government's policy. In January this year, Modi said, India is Bishwa Guru, and we are supplying with the vaccine king of the world. We are supplying to 80 countries. And look at what happened after the second wave came. We are sadly lacking in, I see in my constituency every day, people clamoring from vaccine, not getting them. States have no access to vaccine. Our state wanted to buy vaccine to vaccinate people. It was not available. And yesterday, the government has said that 73 lakh vaccine doses are available. And some 24 lakhs are in the pipeline. Now, with that and a population of 130 crores, can you cover vaccination? I think that vaccine policy has been a major failure. As you rightly said, flip-flops by the government over vaccine. Which vaccine? How? This has also been a major failure. And you look at this, that we should have got Pfizer, BioNTech, Moderna, Johnson & Johnson. Why did we delay so much? If those people who can afford these vaccines take them, then the rest of the vaccine will be free from the common people. Their policy has been a disaster, if I may say. We may be patting ourselves on the back with a minor victory with nine nations, including those like Iceland and Estonia, you know how many people live there. We must remember our major follies. We must not commit any more mistakes, because mistakes mean people's lives. Many people have died. As you know, Navika, the list is unending. The total tally of COVID-19 cases is 3 crore. And the death toll is almost 4 lakhs. It's a sad situation, pathetic situation. Let's not get the government any credit. It is their business to deliver vaccines to state. It is states. It is their business to
Professor Roy, I have no quarrel with what you are saying. Yes, there have been problems. Yes, there have been problems, and yes, the manner in which, we've gone on, at least in the second wave, has created a lot of pain as far as the vaccination policy is concerned. But the fact is the turnaround was very quick. Whether it was getting control over the second wave, whether it was improving on the vaccination policy, or whether it was the situation with EU. At least that you will agree with, Smita Prakash. Talk of the UPA government where it used to take, weeks and weeks for decisions to be taken. We have to recognize it.
Respectfully, sir, Brazil's decision is based on a corruption issue. It's not, got nothing to do with the efficacy of Bharat Biotech. The Bharat Biotech vaccine has proved effective against the Alpha as well as the Delta version. So there is another thing which I want to point out, Navika, is that a drug company, when it applies for approval for travel, they are not they're not selling drugs. For example, if Bharat Biotech or Serum Institute, they're not going to be selling it to the US, right? So when they apply, they're not applying, that is not their focus. They want to supply drugs to people who are buying their drugs, which includes domestic as well as foreign countries. So they won't apply for, say, the US for travel purposes. I'm just saying, suppose the US had travel thing that you need to have a travel issue, like a pass, like the EU has. So that's why I guess they were lax in applying for a travel related pass or a sales related pass, not for an efficacy, mind you. This is only for travel and sale. So this is where the problem has occurred. It is a process. That is why these expensive procedures were not probably in the priority list of either Bharat Biotech or SII. Now that they have been, that has been done. And frankly, this exceptionalism by EU is so unfair. Now, the other point which you pointed out, Navika, I think the soundbite that you had of the Samajwadi Party spokesperson, that kaun ja raha hai? Who's going to Europe? Who's going to the US right now? There are no international flights till the end of this month, and by the end of this month there will be approvals that the SII will get, and hopefully Covaxin too. And till then, if there is emergency travel, there is Vande Bharat flight which is happening. So the priority has been vaccinate your people. I think the focus has to be on that. And as far as Mr. Ghosh pointed out, that it's right that there were people who, several people, thousands of people who died in the second wave. So where was the focus of either Mr. Poonawalla or Mr. Modi or anybody in the Indian cabinet? Vaccinate your people. Get that done. International travel follows later.
Well, Sujata Paul, that's the real point. The point is, has everything been hunky-dory? Absolutely not. Have there been problems? Absolutely yes. But at least let's celebrate and acknowledge when there are victories, and victories like these where 9 countries have at least come on board. And I'm sure, that's how international pressures work. 9 countries come on in a couple of days, 3 days, 1 week, the others will also begin to see the merit. And that's the way things work on a global platform. Why don't we just acknowledge the little victories,
we admire
even
your
if you
optimism.
Want to call it little at this moment?
Oh, really? Is this a real
It's
victory?
Good to be optimistic. What if we all are pessimistic, Professor Roy?
No, we would like to be optimistic. But,
look at the situation.
What are we doing?
People dying, dead body floating in the Ganges. People fighting in the vaccination line. Everything is pessimistic. What have the government done? Look at what's happening on the ground. Every day fight in vaccination line.
Yes. So
look at the dead bodies floating
in
the Ganges.
We were on the way to becoming Vishwa Gurus. We were looking for Apada, Apsar in Apada last year. Around this time, our Prime Minister was telling us. And now we've got the Grand Royal Snuff. Because there are 9 countries who the government is going after when it is not the work of the government. I am amazed at what is being said, because is this the work of the government or is this the work of Serum Institute of India? And the WHO list is in front of me, and it very clearly, EMA list is in front of me, and there are 4 more vaccines which are under review. So none of the vaccines that we are discussing are there. We are talking about ifs and buts, that other Poonawala who got bypassed security but went off to London. We are speaking about Bharat Biotech, and the owner of Bharat Biotech gets bypassed security and sits, you know, at home. What are they doing? Is this governance? Is this some kind of banana republic where there is no protocol being followed? The procedure, the first procedure must have been between the government and SIIA.
Gaurav Bhatia, Gaurav Bhatia, Sujata Paul. सुजाता पॉल ने तो इसको कोविशील्ड कोवैक्सीन रिपब्लिक से सीधा बनाना रिपब्लिक बना दिया है. रिस्पॉन्ड टू हर
नाविका. आई थॉट शी इज अ पॉलिटिकल एनालिस्ट बट इट सीम्स दैट शी इज द अनऑफिशियल स्पोक्सपर्सन ऑफ द पॉलिसी पैरालिसिस फर्स्ट वाइल यूपीए गवर्नमेंट. But let me respond to her first.
Yes, Abda, Abdikari, Abda mein Abdikari,
can she be quiet?
Can she? If you're going to get personal, you're going to get it personal from me too.
Can she be quiet? Navika, please.
Yes, make your point. Make your point, Gaurav.
Yes, thank you. Abda mein afsar to ye hota hai ki Punjab mein Fateh Kit corruption scam was unearthed. आपदा में अवसर ये भी होता है देन वैक्सीन विच आर प्रोवाइडेड
बाय द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट. यू डू नॉट हैव आंसर्स टू द क्वेश्चंस आई रेज.
कैन यू टेल मी
व्हाट इज द एग्रीमेंट साइन बिटवीन एसआईआई और बायोटेक आईसीएमआर.
माय राइट इज इंटैक्ट. आई विल रिस्पोंड इन द मैनर आई वांट टू.
नो आस्क नॉट टू शाउट. डोंट गो टू पंजाब. स्टिक टू द टॉपिक प्लीज.
यू विल नॉट टेल मी. टेल दैट टू राहुल गांधी.
Sujata Paul, allow him to respond to you. I'm running out of time. Yes, Mr. Bhatia.
Yes, and aapka mein aise ye bhi hota hai when vaccines provided by the central government are given to the private hospitals so that they only reach the rich. And they are sold at 3 times the price. But leave it at that. Now, Navika, let us not ignore the fact that the vaccination drive that is being undertaken by our country is the largest in the world. And yes, you may say that enough has not been done, or maybe there is a flip-flop. I will say it very responsibly. There is no flip-flop. Rather, 33.5 crore vaccine doses have been inoculated. This is the highest in the world. We beat US because Chinese data doesn't come out. There is no transparency. Third, from 21st of June, the average number of vaccinations that have taken place are around 60 lakhs, which itself is a big achievement for
us. Wrong data.
And going forward, this number is
going to be wrong data.
We have done a good job. Yes, there might be certain issues, but with the firm resolve of the Prime Minister and the government, we will ensure that India leads the way.
Well, all I want to say is that there is a long path ahead of us. We don't know how many more waves. We don't know what is the kind of, impact that it's going to have on the people, not just in India, but across the world. But what we do know is that small little baby steps, also when they are taken, they should be celebrated. They should be acknowledged because नेगेटिविटी तो बहुत है दुनिया में. थोड़ा सा पॉजिटिव हो जाएं थोड़ी देर के लिए तो इसमें कोई बुराई है? दैट्स द ओनली पॉइंट आई वांट टू मेक. आई एम नॉट सेइंग दैट द ऑपोजिशन हैज नॉट मेड मिस्टेक्स और द गवर्नमेंट हैज नॉट मेड मिस्टेक्स, बट व्हेन द ऑपोजिशन कम्स अप टू स्पीड एंड बिगिंस टू रिकॉग्नाइज दैट वैक्सीन हेजिटेंसी हैज टू बी एंडेड, दे शुड बी सेलिब्रेटेड. एंड व्हेन द गवर्नमेंट सेज ओके आवर पॉलिसी didn't work really by giving it to the states, let's come back to the centralized policy, it's a step forward to protect every Indian citizen. And that also needs to be celebrated. And that's where we leave this debate.